Today we will talk about a number of different boards that we make that makes it possible to record data for sensors. This is for temperature sensors. This board takes 10 temperature sensors and it has a USB port. So you just plug it into your computer and you can measure different temperatures. This is one for measuring pressure. This is a Raspberry Pi computer. This is for measuring current. This one is for controlling some AC outputs, heaters, for example. And this is for controlling DC output, so turning on and off valve, for example. All of these boards has USB-C, and you plug it directly into your computer. And now I'm going to show how that works. For showing this, I'm going to use the PuTTY application. There's hundreds of different applications you can use for serial port connection. This one is available on Windows, Mac, and Linux, and you can download for free in many places. To see which of your, this is on Windows, you go to Device Manager and you can see that my COM port 4, 5, 7, and 8. And I know that I'm going to connect to port number 8. I'm just going to using the serial port here, port 8. And then I need to set the baud rate to this speed. And then I click Connect and you can see right away the data starts streaming in. This board has 10 channels, like I said. Right now there's a temperature sensor plugged into channel number 5, and then there's the internal board temperature is around 32 degrees Celsius here in my office, and then there's some status bits over here, and all of these are text lines and they come in 10 lines per second, so 10 hertz. And now I'm going to try to dip my temperature sensor into a glass of hot water, and you can see that the temperature of the temperature sensor starts rising. Soon it'll reach above 50 degrees C, and I'll just take it out again, and this is how simple it is. I'm going to move the temperature sensor over to port number 1. And you can see right away that the data starts streaming into port number 1. It takes a little bit of time before it settles to the right temperature. You can also type a command. In this case, I'm going to type serial. And And you can see here that it gives you a serial number of this board. It says that it's a temperature board and it's using the STM32F401 microcontroller inside. You can see the version number of the software and the PCB and some calibration data. That was all for now.